Good morning. So, look, I don't know everything, okay? Just make that clear. That's my disclaimer. But when people come at me with stuff, like, I have to talk about it. So, somebody basically asked me, you know, keeping a husband is tough. I guess, like, yeah and no. Because it's like, what are you doing that your husband is not staying true to you? Or what are you doing that your husband, maybe like his, I don't know, like his attention is going elsewhere? Or just that person in general. Sometimes it's not even you. And this goes for men and women. I mean, I've been married before. So it's not always a person's fault. Sometimes it's coupled together, like the both of you all. A lot of times what I see in relationships is that people get comfortable. They don't feel like they have to put in any work because they've won the person over and they got them. But that's not true. Like, a marriage is a full-time job until, like, the job is done. You know, you've either just cannot make things right, someone's cheated and you part in ways, or unfortunately, like, that person passes away. But you're always working in your relationship. I mean, for me now, you know, since I'm alone, I'm constantly working my relationship with my kids. I mean, that's all I have right now. You know, I have my children. I mean, I have a lot more things, but this is something that is near and true to me, and I work towards it all the time. So the relationship with my kids mean a lot. And I mean, like, we, you know, like, I bust them down, but my kids chew me out. They're like, "Mama, you know better. Like, you shouldn't do that. You know, why did you say that like that? You could have said that different." So taking in everything that they're telling me and, you know, keeping their feelings into perspective and not just saying, "I'm the mama, I know everything." You know, that's my balanced approach when dealing with them. You know, sometimes people come with outrageous stuff, like silly stuff, like, you know, that is not finna happen. I don't care how heartfelt you feel, like, you pouring your heart out. You know, "I'm not spending $350 on those shoes." You know, something silly like that. But then there comes a time where you make that sacrifice and y'all may meet up. I mean, 50-50 on everything. It might even be 25-75. I'm saying, I got 25 and the child got to have 75%. I don't see the relevancy in spending that type of money on no kind of shoes. But, you know, I'm still compromising. I'm still trying to find a solution or a way to accommodate them. So, you know, like, are you accommodatable? You know, are you doing things? You know, like, are you maybe putting on something cute for your significant other? You know, are you cooking dinner? Are you fulfilling those wifely and husband duties? You know, there's a lot that goes into it. Everybody want to point the finger, but nobody wants to take the blame. Nobody want to say, "Well, you know, I could have did this better," or, "You know, you're right about that. You know, this could have been done differently." It's always, you know, "But that person," and that's not right. You know, everybody is accountable. And sometimes you're just dealing with a person that cannot be true, cannot be faithful. It's not a one woman, one girl's man or woman. So, you know, you have to choose the route you like to take. Can you put on your seatbelt? I do not give that to him. He ain't no good. Or, you know, "She, girl, she trifling. She gonna be like that." I ain't telling nobody to leave their husband or wife. I don't get in those type of, I'm not that type of advice taker. You just don't do that. That is totally up to that person. I'll tell you all in all what I wouldn't do and what I wouldn't tolerate. And I mean, I'm a lot older. I've gotten to a point in my life where I feel like I don't have to take that. And, you know, it's like, you know, you could do what you want to do and you don't take advantage of that. But at the same time, you feel that, you know, you don't have to deal with certain things. And I feel like it shouldn't take you to get older to get to that point. Like, you should talk to people that are older that have been through those type of trials and issues and, you know, see what type of solutions they've had, they've dealt with. You know, I know marriage counseling save you a little bit on your wedding, but, like, before you get into a marriage, you should talk with someone. You know, and all the time it's not your mother or your father. You know, you need to talk to an outside source. You need to talk with someone that, you know, have been married for like 50 plus years. You know, what did you do and how much did you put up with? Because all in all, we are not perfect. I know somebody put up with something. Somebody did. I know about some. Call Kyra back. I know somebody dealt with something. You know, somebody was doing that wasn't right. So what did you do to get through that? So it's a lot. But, you know, those are my pointers, my takeaways when it comes to that. And you have to decide if it's worth fighting for. You have to decide, am I wasting my time? Is this gonna work out? you know, you, that's up to you. You know your worth as an individual. And a lot of times you have to put things to the side, especially if you have kids, because if you're dealing with some emotional and, you know, verbal stuff, then you have to ask yourself, am I now grooming my kids to accept the same behavior that I'm receiving? So it's a lot, you know, especially when you have children, but it just makes sense. You know, it's common sense things. And don't feel that you can get with a person and then you can change them. You are not a person changer. You cannot make a person do what you want them to do. Your holy ways, your demeanor, your beautiful spirit, your awesome and amazing looks cannot change a person. So if that person shows you their ugly face, you take that in consideration when you're saying I do, or I'm gonna bring you around my kids. And me, for one, like, my children got a full-time job to run off any man that comes in our midst. And I'm talking about kids. I got somebody I like you to meet who he is. Where he at? Mama, I want to see his record. What kind of car he drive? Do he got a job? Mommy. How many baby mamas he got? Do he got children? Oh, what? Look, I'm not taking my kids through any of that. I done been around the block 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times. And I don't need to go around the block no more, okay? I'm good where I'm at. And that's just me personally, like how you do it. I stay busy. You know what I'm saying? I perfect my craft. I criticize myself. I make, well, whatever I'm doing, I make it my business to do it even better. So I find creative ways to fill that void. Because everybody got needs. Come on now, we human. But it's like, is that the all that you need? You know, and then like if you do something stupid, like you gonna live with that mistake you did for a quick little moment. You know, it's a lot of stuff you have to ask yourself. And I know people just don't like to talk about things, but I talk about any and everything. You know, if I don't agree with it, I'll still talk about it. Because at the end of the day, if you don't address what's bothering you, then it just stays within you. You don't get the help you need, and then it eats you up inside, you know. And life is not beautiful. You can't dress up mess. You just cannot. But you can address it. You can try to get the help you need for it. You know, I was just talking about this yesterday. It's like, if my life was so perfect and, you know, I just only showed you the nice things that goes on in life, then it's like that would be a facade. And who has time and energy for that? You know, my children do what they want to do. They say what they want to say. I bust them down, give them some love, and we repeat the process. And the same thing if I say something they don't like. Like, they tell me what, Ma, you shouldn't do. But that's how I like my household to be. That's the type of life I want my kids to mimic and instill that same value. If they should have children, I wouldn't recommend it. But if they bring children into this world, those are the suggestions I would want them to play within their kids. Because if you have a facade painted over your face, if you're living that facade, then that's a lot of work. And deep down inside, like, you just nothing anyway. So just be you. And be very open with what you're dealing with. And know that you're not the only one dealing with it, but you can get through what you're dealing with. And it's very simple. You just have to address it. And you have to admit that there is an issue. Because we all got issues. I know I do. But I go and grow through my issues. You know, I don't allow it to consume me. Because if somebody doing something I don't like I cut them off. I don't deal with them. I don't have to put up with people mess. I don't have to put up with my kids mess. I don't have to put up with my dog's mess. You know, we all have choices, and it sounds so just like, I don't care, but I really don't. Because I do what I'm supposed to do, and I make sure that I'm 10 toes down as I tell my kids. So if you can't give me the same in return, cut it. They made that song for me, baby. That's my theme song. I cut you off, because my peace is something I cannot go to the store and buy. I don't care how healthy and wealthy I am. I ain't going to be too healthy and wealthy if I'm around here stressing and dealing with people mess and I'm accepting it. Oh, no. Mm-mm. So self-reflection, knowing your worth, and self-pedestaling your doggone self. Because sometimes it never gets done by others. So you have to do it. You have to go in and make that, you know, joy and peace for you. And that's what I choose now. That's why I choose to be happy. You know, on a bad day, I'm still choosing to be happy, because life is so short. And the more RIP posts I see, the more motivated I am and grounded to be that happy person no matter what. You know, and a trip and a car and a beautiful house and lavish clothes will never do that for me. It is within. It's what's within me that makes me happy. And I want other people to feel it. And like you're able to assist someone else. Like that's like intoxicating. You know, that's something that you just should do, but it's not always done. So, you know, it's just love yourself. That's all I can say. And think about yourself. And don't take nobody's mess. Just don't. Because I'm here to tell you, I love all five of my kids. But even that 10-year-old, you cross me, baby, you cut off. And I just really do not care. You know, that's just how I am right now. And this one, 2020, this was what was instilled in me as a child. And I've instilled it into my kids. And I tweaked it a little bit. You know, I'm not so rough as my upbringing was. But it, trust me, it molded me. It helped me to have tough skin. And it helped me to value me, because I don't need another person to value me before I value myself. You know what I'm saying? So it starts with you. So y'all do that for me, okay? Do that for yourself. Tell yourself that I'm gonna love myself just because I do. And if I don't love myself, then who will? Huh? Yeah? Okay. This is Angel's Cleaning Service, always just sharing a little dose of love with you. And I gotta get me some coffee, because I just won't make it. Decaf, that is. Because you know that caffeine had you like, girl, what's wrong with you? Why are you twitching? What you on? You on them good drugs, and it's called legal drugs that you don't need, okay? All right, y'all. Happy Friday. Have a great day. Don't spend all your money. Sorry. Put some up and love yourself. Bye, y'all. Good morning.